morning, everybody. Our topic today is the month of Kislev. Now, the month of Kislev is a month that has a holiday in it, Hanukkah. It's a holiday that starts in Kislev, and as we know, ends in the next month, the month of Tevet. It's not by an accident that Hanukkah is in Kislev and Tevet, as it is not by an accident that Pesach is in Nisan and Rosh Hashanah in Tishrei and any other holiday at the time that it is. There is a connection between the spiritual potential of the month and the holidays that fall in this month. So we can learn about the month by learning about the holiday, and learning about the holiday by learning about the month, because they are put together because they have a similar potential. So what I'll do today is I'll really do this combination. We'll go from one to the other, and we'll do it next time in Yirtzeh Hashem too, and maybe the time after too. I'll see if I want to do it in two times or three times, because as I said, Tevet is also a share in the story of Hanukkah. And our third class from today will be on Hanukkah yet, so I most probably will do 3 hours on the topic rather than two, and cover the first of Tevet. So we'll start with Hanukkah. Let's see what is the story of Hanukkah, but not the famous fact that we all know, right, that the Jewish people overcame the Greeks, but let's see more. What was the situation in within the Jewish nation before the story of Hanukkah took place, before the miracle of Hanukkah took place? Interestingly enough, the story of Hanukkah, as we have it recorded in the book of Hashmonaim, started with two high priests, Yehoshua and Chonyo, who were brothers and were high priests one after the other. Like other people in the Jewish nation at the time, they were influenced by the Greek culture, and they called themselves Jason and Menelaos. And there was a tension between them in terms of who will be the high priest. When Menelaos had to give up the position for his brother Jason, he went to Nebuchadnezzar, he went to Antiochus, the king of Antiochia at the time, what is today Syria, who ruled over the land of Israel in the as the Greek emperor, and they told him that they will make sure that Torah will be forgotten, that mitzvot will not be kept, and he should give them permission to build a Greek gymnasium in Jerusalem. That's how the story started, right? And obviously he agreed, and he came back to Jerusalem. He came with a few other people, Bnei Tuvia they are called. The group came back to Jerusalem and started to build a gymnasium in Jerusalem. It affected people, obviously, and those who were already more to the left, more influenced by the Greeks, came to the rest of the people and told them, "Hava nichrot brit imamim asher svivoteinu." Let us make a covenant with the nations that are around us, שכן מאז התבדלנו מהם מצאו אותנו תלאות רבות. Because from the time that we separated ourselves from them, in terms of our way of life, many, many difficulties fell upon us. So you want to solve the Jewish problem, right? There is a solution. Assimilate. Don't be different. And then you won't have problems. We heard it many times over and over all through history, right? So that's what they said to the people, and some obviously were influenced. Later on, Jason, who wanted to be the high priest, went also to Antiochus, and gave him tremendous amounts of money in order to give the Jewish people human rights like the Greeks have in Antiochia, and again to get permission to build a gymnasium in Jerusalem. And what he promised was to bring the idol worship of the Greeks into the Jewish nation. And obviously, it was granted whatever he wanted, and this deteriorated even further the situation of the Jewish people. That's what we are told in the book of Hashmonaim. Chazal sum up what took place in this generation with a few sentences, some of them more famous than others, but let's see what they tell us about the spiritual situation, the connection between Hashem and the Jewish people at that time. So that's very famous, that the Malchut, the kingdom, made a decree the Jewish people cannot circumcise the children, cannot establish the Jewish calendar via witnesses the way it was done, and not keep Shabbos. Okay, this is very famous. We are also told that they changed the courts, the Jewish courts, and they forced them to follow and abide by the Greek code of law rather than by Torah. They did not allow to mention the name of Hashem, שלא יזכירו שם שמיים. It was forbidden to mention